Okay, now we are discussing July 2017. July 2017, question 1. FIN 661. July 2017, question 1. Okay, Harry Salvador is an investor. The information on price of the shares monitored by him over the past 4 years are as follows. So, Harry Salvador is monitoring 3 stocks. This is very challenging because you just imagine 2 asset portfolio pun is confusing enough. But now we have 3 asset portfolio. So, the level of confusion is getting a bit higher. Okay. And then satu lagi, another thing is dia ni, dia bagi kita from raw data, we have to calculate monthly return, annual return tu, kan? Using this formula, okay. Since we only have about 20 minutes left of our time, it is impossible for us to do every single stock. So all I can do is just show you how to calculate lemons, and then for Harrods and Bowick, you do at home. Okay, for Harrods and Bowick, you buat di rumah. Sekarang ni saya nak tunjuk pada awak macam mana nak calculate return for lemon saja. You have to use this formula. So this is July 2017. July 2017. Question 1A. Untuk kira the annual return, first you have to calculate the annual return. Macam tadi contoh Kailis dengan Coralis tu, your job is a bit easy because return tu dah bagi dah, dah calculate dah. Dia dah masuk kan? Now you have to calculate the return tu. You have to come up with the return tu. Step pertama tu pun you tak ada lagi tau. Macam tadi tu dia dah calculate dah kan? Masuk kan? So ini you have to use this formula. Return is equal to ending value minus beginning value plus cash flow over beginning value. Ini kena pakai formula ni dulu. Ending value minus beginning value plus cash flow over beginning value. Ending value, okay. Now kita tak tahu satu lagi masalah. Dia tak bagi tahu, they don't tell us whether this information is on 31st December or 1st January. Satu lagi masalah adalah these figures diberi ni, dia tak sebut ada sama ada ini adalah harga pada 1 Januari ke ataupun pada 31 Disember. We can only know bila kita tengok answer scheme. Tapi dalam peksa, you tak ada answer scheme kan? Jadi kalau you tengok, if you look at the answer scheme, you tengok 2014, 2015 dan 2016, maka barulah kita tahu bahawa dia merujuk kepada this is actually year end price. Maksud sini, kalau macam lemons ni, 170 ni, actually adalah harga pada on the 31st December. So, this is referring to harga on the 31st December lah. 31st December of 2013, 31st December of 2014 dan seterusnya. So, kalau you calculate, for 2014, we calculate on the lemon because of due to time constraint. So I just show you how to calculate for lemons. So for 2014 return adalah ending value. What is the ending value? Kalau 31 Januari 2013 RM1.70, 31 Januari 2014 adalah RM1.90 kan? So ending value is 190 minus beginning value of 170 plus dividend for that year. Pada tahun 2014, dividend dia adalah 5%, 50 cents. Cash flow is usually referring to dividend. Cash flow is usually referring to dividend and beginning value of 170. To get your answer in percentage, multiply by 100. I mean, what do you have? You will get, if the answer scheme is correct, you get 41.18%, right? So you get 41.18%. And then for 2015, 15 for 2015 ER is equal to 120 minus 1.9 plus so for 2015 we have dividend of 80 cents 0.80 minus divided by 1.90 multiplied by 100 when what do we have 5.26 okay and the last one is 2016 ER is equal to 0.9 minus 1.2 plus okay there's no dividend payment for 2016 plus 0 over 120 you multiply all this by 100 and you will have negative 25% minus 25.00 in Carlyle what is the name of the company sebelum ni Kailis kan in Kailis dia start dengan sini saja faham tak in Kailis and Corelis tu dia start dengan sini dah tapi in this case you have to find this figure kan so you have to go one step backward satu langkah ke belakang lagi daripada tu okey similarly you repeat the same process for Harrods and Bawick you repeat the same process for Harrods and Bawick dipendekkan cerita to cut things short kita dapatlah so sini you nak dapatkan return average return you campurkan you divide by 3 you campurkan 41.18 5.26 and minus 25 you get 21.44 divided by 3 because why 3 3 years kan and you have 7.15 1415 lah okay so you repeat the same process for Harrods and for Bawick kalau if you understand how to get this lemon I'm sure you can easily calculate Bawick dan juga Harrods and juga Bawick okay payah kan tapi ialah payah pun kita kena buat okay the second part so saya skip part Harrods and Bawick tu because you can do it at home masa tak sempat kita buat ni okay yang kedua the second part dia kata calculate the portfolio's return and risk calculate the portfolio's return and risk if Harry Salvador wishes to invest only in two stocks that report the highest individual return. Okay, look at the answer scheme. Kalau dia nak invest dalam dua saham yang mempunyai return paling tinggi, dia kena invest in what? Yang mana paling tinggi antara tiga ni? Dia nak dua, the two highest. It should be Harrods and Bawick. Harrods 39.75 kan? Bawick 12.08. So they should combine Harrods and Bawick. Okay, faham tak tu? Lemons will be left out because lemon has the lowest return. Yang tu kita tengok maknanya dia kena Harrods and Bawick. Kemudian dia kata lagi, kemudian dia soalan dia kata, assume the two selected stocks are equally weighted. That means 0.5% Harrods and 0.5% Bawick. So in terms of weightage, 50-50. Yeah, in terms of weightage, 50-50. And this is the most important part. Dia kata lagi, and perfectly negatively correlated. Perfectly negatively correlated, maknanya correlation coefficient between Harrods and Bawick is minus 1. So you don't have to calculate lah. Awak tak payah calculate dah. Dia terus saja bagi kita correlation coefficient of Harrods and Barwick is -1. Ha, jadi kita punya tugas is made so much easy. Kalau tak bagi tahu, you kena cari correlation pakai RI minus RI darat-darat semua kan. So sekarang ni tak payah dah buat macam tu because dia kesian kat awak nak kira banyak sangat. So they simply let us know. So you write down the information here. First is we decide to invest in Harrods and Barwick. Why? Because these are the two highest, kan? So invest in Harrods and Barwick. What is the weightage? W1 is 0.5 and W2 is 0.5. How do we know? Because they kata equally. And then they also tell us that correlation coefficient between Harrods and Barwick or R12 is equal to -1. So there's no need for us to calculate because they kata perfectly negatively correlated. Now you are asked to calculate return. Return senang lah. Okay, expected return of the portfolio is equal to W1 ER1 plus W2 multiplied by ER2, iaitu 0.5. What is the expected return of Harrods? 39.75 plus 0.5 expected return of Barwick multiplied by what is the expected return of Barwick? 12.08. What is the answer? Berapa? 25.92%. Okay, tapi sebenarnya tak semudah tu juga eh. Bila kita nak calculate expected standard deviation of the portfolio. Standard deviation of the portfolio is equal to W1 to the power 2, standard deviation 1 to the power 2 plus W2 to the power 2, standard deviation 2 to the power 2 plus 2, W1, W2, standard deviation 1, standard deviation 2, R12. Kan? Okay? So, W senang. Standard deviation kena calculate lah. Standard deviation kena calculate. Ha, ini satu cerita pula lagi satu hal kan. Ha, you kena calculate standard deviation of Harrods and standard deviation of Barwick. So saya tak tunjuk pada awak sebab ada dalam answer scheme ni. Cuma answer scheme ni, I believe standard deviation tu dia divide by, sepatutnya divide by N minus 1. Tapi dia divide by N sahaja. That's why awak tengok jawapan yang tulis tangan tu. Tulis tangan tu I believe saya dah modified dah tu. Kan? Nampak tak tu kan answer scheme kan ada yang type, ada tulis tangan kan? Kenapa ada two different figures? Because yang dia type ni is based on divided by n. Eh, kalau yang saya tulis tangan divided by n minus 1 kan? So use the answer that is handwritten answer. Bila dah dapat standard deviation, kerja awak senanglah. R12 dah is given kan? R12 tadi berapa? What is the value of R12? -1. So yang lain tu kena calculate dan akhirnya you dapatlah standard deviation dia adalah bersamaan dengan belakang tu 14.61%. 14.61%. Saya skip banyaklah lah sebabnya dah penat dah, letih dah kat keempat dah. Kan? Tapi dia punya cerita dia gitulah. Kan? Banyak dah ni saya potong. Okay, I think we stop here dan kita akan tukarkan direction camera ni ke belakang pula.